So I expect some kind of announcement within the first week of April that there will be some sort of a global currency.
Well, it's in today's paper, too, by the head of the IMF. It's official. They'll have it out in a couple of months.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. We'll be back with Alan Watt after this. It's the Info Warrior with Jason Bermas. Go get the podcast at theinfowarrior.com or check out the video at prisonplanet.tv. InfoWarrior with Jason Bermas. We are joined by Alan Watt of CuttingThroughTheMatrix.com. Alan, I want to get your take on China banning YouTube officially today, taking it off the internet for Chinese citizens. You know, in the past year, we've really seen a push for China to come into the global arena. I mean, we had them host the Olympics. We seem to be adopting more of their policy. You know, we borrowed trillions and trillions of dollars from them. And now this super state, this super nation, has officially banned YouTube. I mean, this is, I think, the third biggest site on the internet. Can you speak to that?
Yes. China, according to the United Nations, is the model state for the world. In other words, we've all to copy the system of China, ultimately, because they want a collectivist system. And the big think tank of the Club of Rome said that in their own book, the first global revolution. They said collectivism was the best way of managing a world population. So they've based it on China, where you have a one-party system, a totalitarian party. To get into commerce in China, you must join the party and become a member, a card-carrying member, and attend the local meetings or your city meetings. And China, if you notice, they might have banned that. However, we also have laws getting enacted right now. Australia was the first one to come out with it, where if you go into what's claimed are banned sites, and they won't give you a list of what sites are banned yet, they will start fining you $11,000 per day. So we in the West will start losing our rights and freedoms as well to the internet altogether, except for data tracking and gossip and so on, and emails for the governments, as they start to take away Google here and all the other sites that we look into. We have to emulate China, so I'm not surprised at all about this. We've had, I think it was Jay Rockefeller recently talked about how dangerous the internet was, and he actually said, would it be better if we'd never given it to the people in the first place?
Yeah, that is true, and one of the sites that Australia has officially banned and put on the list is WikiLeaks, and this is a site that notoriously puts out government documents that, you know, the mainstream media really just refuses to talk about. And, you know, speaking of documents the mainstream media really refuses to talk about, or at least talk about in substance, this Give Act, you know, it is anything but giving. It's really taking. It is compulsory service for 12-year-olds and up, middle school and up, 50 hours to start, 100 hours for college students. Once you're out of high school, you'll be forced into some kind of a secondary school or some kind of another bureaucratic program. But they also tacked on this centralized electronic citizen verification system. And, you know, in the past, they've tried to pass the Real ID Act. They've put chips in our passports. They've done everything in their power to really put a stranglehold on the people here, but this to me is the most wide-reaching one, in the fact that this is a citizen verification system for everyone, including students, and they're going to be using the Department of Education to test this and then implement it.
Yes, in a sense too, and this would be, the public don't realize that what you're living through in your entire life, in fact, is a continuation of a system as it upgrades itself to the next part, the next part. We saw them pass the bills for school to work. That was part of it. That was based on the Chinese or the Soviet system, both actually. So they'll train you. They want to train you for a particular job. And if they want you to be a joiner, a plumber, a carpenter, whatever, then that's all you'll be taught eventually. Ultimately, down the road, that's all you'll be taught. If they want you to be a good party bureau chief or whatever, they'll train you for that. Or the new type of worldwide KGB, you'll be trained for that. So you're quite right. It's more than just what they say. But mainly, here's what it is. It's a record of each individual and their potential for being a problem down the road. In other words, they're looking for thinkers. And you'll notice a big part of this budget, this so-called compulsory volunteerism, is going towards education. You're looking at political ideology indoctrination. That's what it's going to be. So we're really under tyranny right now. And if you get one generation who've grown up with the scientific indoctrination, it's game over. You can't talk to them. You can't reason with them. They'll be pulling the older people out of the houses, off for the disposal unit, basically, because they ruined the planet for them, etc. This is political ideology, and we've got to understand that.
And speaking of ruining the planet, I really want to get into their global carbon tax system that's being proposed right now. Not only in legislation by the UN, but by the United States. I mean, we've got Tennessee talking about buying carbon credits in anticipation of this being passed. That, and we're going to take your calls for Alan Watt. It's 866-582-9933. Call in, ask Alan a question. We'll be back after this. It's the Info Warrior with Jason Bermas, PrisonPlanet.tv, Infowars.com. It's the Info Warrior with Jason Bermas. We have Alan Watt of CuttingThroughTheMatrix.com on the line. If you'd like to ask him a question, it is 866-582-9933. Alan, I want to get into this carbon tax thing because this is the next step of control. We're all going to be made to feel guilty about the Earth and climate change and we're to blame. And it's this new control grid. Instead of paying taxes on other things, they want you to pay taxes on the environment. In other words, how many cars you have, how big is your home, how much trash are you producing, how many children do you have, which they do want to regulate. Just look at China. One child policy's there for decades now. And this article is out of Reuters today. Idled U.S. farmland may be a large carbon sink, USDA. So the U.S. is basically saying they need, the Department of Agriculture is saying we need to buy up all this farmland, and they're saying it's 33.7 million acres, and federalize it because it's emitting too much carbon. Ooh. Why don't you explain this system to people?
Well, again, apart from being a complete con, you see, right now they're putting laws through and an ideology to convince people they're a burden on the planet itself and the ecosystem. So you would get born into a system of guilt for being alive in the first place. That's really at the crux of this. This is how it will, why it will work, in fact. And it will interfere, it will control every single part of your existence, even right down to if you can breed, if you should breed, and the cost of it, and so on and so on. It's a complete farce, utter farce, really. And it's abstract nonsense. It's Wizard of Oz stuff. And they're well aware of it at the top. Now, the Club of Rome, again, is the premier think tank for working out systems to control the population of the planet. It comes up with ideas, and then it passes it down to other think tanks that work on it and implement it into society. They pass their ideas on to the Rand Corporation, for instance. And they put in their own book, The First Global Revolution, that in the 1970s, they had looked for something to unite the planet, a common enemy. And they looked at even alien invasion, what would work with the public, were they gullible enough, etc. Then they said no. Eventually they hit on the idea of man being at war with the planet and vice versa. Therefore, man would be the enemy. In their own words, they said that would fit the bill.
That is just incredible. And, you know, the other project you were talking about is Project Bluebeam, where they said, you know, we would stage this alien invasion or possibly put holograms in the sky of religious figures and, you know, cull the populations into, you know, believing that we needed a one world order or a world government to combat this sort of thing. And it seems like they, instead of conquest, they wanted to go through consent. And they will get consent through incrementally telling the people that global warming is real. You know, your SUV is terrible. I saw a report out of the Telegraph about 3 weeks ago where they were saying that United States use of toilet paper was actually worse than gas-guzzling SUVs. In other words, I'm not even supposed to wipe my behind when I go to the bathroom. I mean, this is just insanity.
It is an insanity, but they can make any crazy system work if they can convince enough people, especially the young, bring them up with indoctrination. They can make you believe anything. And they've said that in their own books, by the way. They can make the general public eventually believe anything with the proper indoctrination. Bertrand Russell said, there is no nonsense so arrant that it cannot be made the general creed, meaning belief, of the vast majority by adequate government action. That's what he said at one of the world meetings and in one of his own books. And they can really, really do it. They can make you believe in it. They could make you believe that it's your fault that the sky goes dark at night, if they wanted to.
I was watching a DVD out there that featured Edward Bernays, and Bernays telling a story about how he got the other half of the population, women, to smoke, and how they staged this. And, they had all these women go out with cigarettes and made it the cool, hip thing to do.
Societal women. They were well-known, top societal ladies that the rest would emulate. And he understood the psychology of that, that the masses follow those with the personality cult like Hollywood. And so he was well aware of what he was doing,
Yeah, I mean, it's incredible. They get this group of women to start smoking out in public. They stage a news story, and then really it just starts to pick up, and all of a sudden women are smoking.